Graceland story is a very interesting story in that it's a very good example of how a collaboration works, even when you're not aware of it occurring. The track is one of the early tracks because I only did 5 tracks in South Africa. On the sessions that I did with Forere, who was the accordion player, plays on Boy in the Bubble, we did a few other tracks. One of the tracks, I said, you know, I like only the drums on this track. I don't really want anything else. I don't want the accordion or bass. I just want the drums. And the drums were something like a kind of a traveling rhythm in country music. I'm a big Sun Records fan, and early 50s, mid 50s Sun Records. You'd hear that drum beat a lot. Fast Johnny Cash type of rhythm. And somewhere later in the week of recording, when I had put together a rhythm section of Ray Peary and Bagidi Kumalo and Isaac Machali as the rhythm section, I said to Ray one day, I like this drum pattern. Take a listen to it and see if it does anything for you. You know, it sounds like a kind of a country thing to me. So he started to play his version of American country, Ray. He was in the key of E, and then he was playing, because he's playing electric, but he'd be up over here, you know, like. And the drums are going down. Oh, then he went, which is a relative minor chord to that key. I said, hey, that's interesting that you played a minor chord, because all the music that I've been recording in South Africa, with the exception of the Sotho music, it was all 3-chord major chords. There was never a minor chord. There were times when I would ask Black Mambazo to sing a minor chord. They couldn't sing a minor chord. They just didn't hear it. So he put in this minor chord, and I said, that's interesting. Why'd you do that? He said, I was just imitating the way you write. Well, I said, well, play this lick over it. Da, do, dee, da, da, do, da, do, da. Ba, do, dee, da, ba, do, dee, da, da, do, dee, da, da. In an overdub. And he did, and it was a really nice mix. And Bagidi was playing. Dum, 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 dum. Has a beautiful emptiness to it. I think that's part of what makes me think that it's something like Sun Records, you know, when it was just a few instruments and nothing really much except slapback echo and a song. There's also another connection musically that's in there, and that is there's a pedal steel guitar in there, which is, a country instrument. But it's also a West African instrument, and the guy who played it, his name was Divola Adejapu. He played with King Sunny Ade's band. You know, I wanted to hear what that lick sounded like. Dee, 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 dee. Seemed like it would be a very good pedal steel lick. And it was a great pedal steel lick, but it was also a great Ray Peary performance. Thank you. interesting is that Ray reaches into his memory for some kind of approximation of what he thinks of as American country. And Bugitti plays straight ahead to the African groove. And so the two musics find a commonality. And the lyric expresses that.
I'm going to Graceland.
Don and Phil Everly came in and sang. I always heard that song as a perfect Everly Brothers song.
Poor boys and pilgrims with families, and we are going to Graceland.
I was down in South Africa in, I think, February, maybe early March, and I think I didn't go down to Memphis until maybe May. Brought it home and I was trying to write to it. I would, sing these lines about Graceland, because I'm going to get rid of the Graceland part because, I mean, what's Graceland got to do with South Africa or anything like that? So that's got to go. Just a question of, what I'm going to replace it with. But then I couldn't replace it with anything. I was always singing that. And finally I said, I don't know, maybe I'm supposed to go to Graceland. I've never been. Maybe I'm supposed to go on a trip and see what I'm writing about. So I did. And then I began to describe the trip, the Mississippi Delta, because I was driving up from Louisiana, where I had cut the Zydeco track on Graceland. I was driving from Highway 61. I'm just writing about what the countryside looked like.
The Mississippi Delta was shining like a national guitar. Following the river down the highway through the cradle of the Civil War. I'm going to Graceland, to Memphis, Tennessee. I'm going to Graceland.
And finally got there to Graceland and just, made a tour through Graceland. But what's interesting about all of this is that the part of me that had Graceland in my head, I think subconsciously was reacting to what I first heard in the drums, which was a kind of Sun Records country blues amalgam. And what Ray was doing was mixing up his oral recollections of what American country was and what kind of chord changes I played. So the whole song really is just one sound evoking a response, and that eventually became a lyric that evoked, instead of being specifically about a South African subject or even a political subject, it became a traveling song that had to do with the original sound, which was the drums and Sun Records and Graceland. That's really the secret of world music, is people are able to listen to each other and make associations and play their own music that sounds like it fits into another culture. And that's how it works, and that's how it worked then. Story of Graceland.